Hello everyone, I hope everyone is doing okay and enjoying the bull market. Today I will teach you one of the most effective strategies of cryptocurrency trading which you can start to use today. You can use this technique both while day trading or swing trading. Your chance of making consistent profits while trading Bitcoin is way higher with this method. Please note that nothing in this video or in this channel is investment advice, and the Trading Journal channel is not responsible for any kind of loss. Remember that before starting to use any strategy, you should backtest it. Don't believe that a simple strategy can make you a Bitcoin millionaire just because some YouTube trading mentor told you so. Go test this strategy for yourself before losing money. So let's talk about the strategy. If you are not a new trader, you must be familiar with the indicator MACD. If you have never heard of it, don't worry, we will take a look at what does it mean. MACD stands for Moving Average Convergence Divergence, which is not the most effective way to say it. MACD is a leading trend following momentum indicator which uses two different exponential moving averages. You can see MACD uses 12 periods EMA and 26 periods EMA. But the main advantage of MACD comparing to moving averages is that moving averages just indicate trend while MACD indicates both the trend and the momentum. Because MACD shows us the momentum, it shows us the strength of the trend. And that is why it is one of the most used indicators by traders. First, I will show you how to read the MACD indicator. To check the MACD indicator, I will use the site tradingview.com, which you can use for free. After opening the trading view, you can add an indicator clicking this button. You can search for any indicator you like. As you can see, MACD has one blue and one red line, and it also includes some red and green bars. The zero point is our baseline. The red line is called the signal line and the blue line is called the MACD line. Reading MACD indicator is really simple. When the blue line crosses up the red line below zero point, it is considered as a buy signal. And when the blue line crosses down the red line over zero point, it is considered as a sell signal. But we should be more picky and try to look for signals that are far from the baseline. Also, we can never trade trusting just one indicator. Now, let's take a look at the bars. Bars show us the difference between two lines. It can be hard to see, but when you check the baseline point, you can easily see that the height of the bar equals to the difference between two lines. At the beginning of the video, we saw that MACD uses two different exponential moving averages. So, blue and red lines are 12 period EMA and 26 period EMA respectively. That means bars represent the difference between two EMAs. So, bigger bars mean strong momentum and the small bars mean the loss of momentum. Now, you know how to read the MACD indicator. But you should never trade using one single indicator. The best way to use an indicator is to use it with other technical analysis tools, such as candlestick patterns or other indicators. The MACD indicator has one big disadvantage. The MACD indicator by itself is not enough to identify the long-term direction of the trend. If you want to be a great trader in the long run, you should always be trading in the same direction as the trend. You will be most likely to lose money if you bet against the trend. To identify the long run trend, we will be using 200 period EMA. In our strategy, we will have a couple of rules to follow in order to avoid mistakes. We have three basic rules, which will make us picky, but they will increase our win ratio. Our first rule is to only open a trade when the MACD signal and the trend are in the same direction. Our second rule, we should only take trends when the crossover points of MACD lines are far from the zero point. Our last rule is really simple, but I think it is one of the most important rules for any kind of trade. We should always set a stop loss and our risk-reward ratio should always be higher than 2. If you don't know how to calculate the risk-reward ratio, you can check our video in the description box. The last rule should apply to all of your trades if you want to make money in the long run. Now, let's do some practice and look at some charts to find great trades. First, I will take a look at the 4-hour Bitcoin US dollar chart and try to find possible trades. It is the time frame which I usually use while swing trading. Here, you can see our first trade. We have a possible trade because the price is over 200 EMA and our MACD crossover is far from the baseline. So I will open a trade with a risk-reward ratio of at least 2. What I mean by risk-reward ratio is I will risk roughly 1% of my capital to win more than 2%. As you can see, our first trade was a win. So let's say that our capital was $1,000. With the first trade we took, we made $20 profit. And here you can see our second trade, which also satisfies our first two rules. So I will open another trade there. Again, I will risk only 1% to make 2. As you can see, our second trade was also a winner, but be careful. If our take profit target was at 2.5% instead of 2, it could be a loss because it will trigger our stop loss point. But still, we made under $20 with this trade. Here you can see another possible trade, but I will not take it. Since the cursor point is close to our baseline, this trade does not satisfy our second rule. And also here you can see another crossover, but this trade breaks our first rule because the price is lower than 200 EMA. It means that there is a negative trend at the moment. But keep in mind that you can also open short positions in negative trends when the MACD crossover happens in the opposite direction. On this point, there is a possible trade, but it is more risky because the price just break our 200 EMA line. There is a possibility that it is a fake breakout, and the moving average could act as a resistance. So be careful while taking this kind of trades. But still, we just made under $20 with this trade. So it has become 3 wins in a row. Here, this is our next trade because it does not break any of our rules. But this time we took a loss. However, on the bright side, since our risk per trade was only 1%, we just lost $10. We have another winner trade here. In this trade, we could have made way more than 2% profit. But in this practice, we only took trades with the target price of 2%. So here, we made under $20. Okay, I'm really happy that finally we found a possible short trade opportunity in this example. As you can see, the price is under the moving average, and we have a MACD crossover over the baseline point. So I will open a short position here. We lost this trade, but don't worry, in our strategy, it was a trade worth taking, and our risk was only $10. And here, we have a nice trade also. It does not break any of our rules, so we can open a position here. This trade was also a winner. So we had a total of 7 trades, from which 5 of them were winners, and 2 of them were losers. Since our profits were $20 a trade, we made $100 while losing just $20 in 2 losses. After 7 trades, we made a profit of $80, which is an 8% profit in just 7 trades. You can find many opportunities with this strategy. Just like we traded Bitcoin, you can also trade other cryptocurrencies such as Ethereum or Ripple. You can also use this technique to trade altcoins with Bitcoin instead of dollars. Even if you do not trade intraday and just take, for example, 10 trades a month, you can still make more than 100% profit a year with this win rate. Remember to always keep a record of your trades like I do, so that you will know the win ratio of your strategy. You should always keep a record of each strategy to understand what works for you and what doesn't. Also, before starting to trade with real money, you should backtest your strategy at least 50 times to learn your win ratio. After seeing the win rate, you will decide to use the strategy or not. And if you think it is good to go, you will be more confident trading with that strategy. I used the strategy I showed you for a couple of years and I got good results with it. But you should never trust a strategy before testing it yourself. Also, remember that money and risk management are way more important than trading strategies. Focus on them first, and never trade with money that you cannot afford to lose. If you're a new cryptocurrency trader, never risk more than 2% of your capital in one trade. Give yourself time to get comfortable while trading. Remember that while trading, you can have losing strikes, like 8 or 10 losses in a row. So you should be managing your money good. Okay everybody, I hope you find this video helpful. And if you have any questions in mind, comment them down. You can find a link in description box to open a Binance account and start trading today. You will get a 10% discount on commissions if you use our link. Hit the like button if you find this helpful, and you can subscribe to our channel if you want new and free trading videos regularly. Also, you can comment down anything you wonder. I am sorry if you find my English hard to understand.
Unfortunately, it is not my mother tongue. If you think this robotic voice is easier to understand, please comment down and give me feedback about which sound should I use in future videos. I am okay with which option you think is better. In future videos, I will use the sound that is most commented. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching. Good luck with your next trades.